and a broadcaster, and thank you for taking the time out to have a look at some of the other things I do.
Are you after an after-dinner speaker?
Radio 4 commentator, I'm speaking to you from the unorganised meeting. I'm sorry, I'm speaking to you from the UN organised meeting. Trades union baron. These are unfounded allegations, and we intend to find the alligators. Another trades union baron. 10% of nothing is nothing. We demand 15%.
Frances Edmonds was voted top female after-dinner speaker by The Times.
Another Radio 4 commentator. I'm speaking to you from Jerusalem, the Mecca of Israeli tourism. Newscaster Trevor MacDonald in the 10 o'clock news as was. Daphne du Maurier dies in 2 minutes after the break. My own absolute favourite, ladies and gentlemen, on this I'm going to leave you. BBC Radio leaves during the 91 Gulf War. US troops have just invaded Kuwait. Oh, yeah, I'm sorry, US troops have just invaded Kuwait.
For your conference, are you looking for a host who's clever, colourful and charismatic?
Quite unsolicited, I received a letter through the post from Trevor Parker, the publishing director of Contract Journal. Dear Mrs. Edmonds, it read, will you care to come and speak at our annual dinner? I wrote back. Dear Mr. Parker, can I expect a huge fee? He wrote back. Dear Mrs. Edmonds, no, you can't. You'd really expect the publishing director of such an august publication to be able to spell the word can't.
Twenty-five years ago today, the first British troops started patrolling the streets of Northern Ireland to help restore peace between the Catholic and Protestant communities.
As a presenter, she'll get the best from your guest.
If it is an IRA bomb, do you think this suggests a new wave of terrorism on the mainland? And if so, why at this point in time?
Well, if you look back over the period since we were recalled from Holiday to Downing Street for that decision, in 25 years ago, 3,000 or more people have been killed.
She's confident on camera.
Men, snoring in the cinema, fantasizing over football, belching into their bowls. It often seems that men belong to a parallel universe, not just the opposite sex. I've taken it upon myself to delve the murky depths of the male psyche. And this week I start by looking at a subject that's close to every woman's heart. Romance.
Does romance ever come into it? Do you ever talk about women?
Sorry.
Do you want to talk about women?
I thought you said romance. Women comes into it.
But not romance.
Women. Yeah. Women. They bring more beer. Yeah.
My wife's a psychiatrist. I'm a case study.
I bet. Do you have partners, girlfriends, wives, divorced
he
wives?
He does.
A wife, a girlfriend?
He does, I don't.
He lies like a flat fish.
I do have a girlfriend.
We lie a lot. Men lie.
It's the wife, she wants a check.
The psychiatrist.
Hello, darling. Sorry, honey.
It's actually your
way. Your way.
She's certainly got the plot.
And when you're asking big questions like what's gone wrong with England cricket and what's going to go wrong with sports at the top level, you have to look down at the grassroots level and understand these poor kids don't have any grass left and they're playing with their Nintendo.
In fact, she could have probably written the plot herself.
My next guest made her writing reputation with a sharp and witty book about accompanying her husband, a test player, on an England cricket tour. Her new novel transports the reader into that powerful and popular world of the very rich, where divided families produce glittering drama. Star of Heaven takes us into the jewellery houses of Paris among the innocent and the greedy. The author is Frances Edmonds. In Star of Heaven, there is a wonderful male character who is called Sharif Khan. He is extraordinarily like a gentleman who sat in that chair not very long ago, Imran Khan. Is there any connection?
There is a connection. I mean, in your introduction you say the glittering jewellery houses of Paris, sure, but this book also takes us to the northwest frontier province, this wonderful land between Afghanistan and Pakistan, a group of tribes, the Pathans.
As a guest on your show, she'll bring fire.
I mean, motor racing. Money meets machismo meets Meccano.
And plenty of fizz.
The trouble with British people, and I hate to have to say this, but it's a wonderfully liberating experience to be on a panel with both John Prescott and Norman Tebbit, because I can be as outrageous as I want and nobody will even notice. You just...
And nothing would stop you.
You just scratch every little English man, and underneath there's a terrible xenophobe. And I'm afraid Mrs. Thatcher in her dealings...
That's not true in France.
Mrs. Thatcher in her dealings with Brussels always lets this come out. Now, Jacques Delors is the perfect bogeyman for her. First of all, he's French. And if we hate any nation on earth, it's the French. Secondly, he's a socialist, which, as you know, in the Thatcher hierarchy of demonology is worse than being a child abuser. And third and most unforgivable, is that the man is an intellectual. Three things.
And he's a man.
Three things which Mrs. Thatcher cannot stand.
I'd particularly carry on with Frances Edmonds. I'd love to hear her carry on. Because
there's no time for any more carry on.
And all this in six different languages.